Sadiq, and it is Free Flow Friday, where we just kind of, you know, talking about, I don't want to say whatever, we do that too, but, you know, just a little bit more looser than we do on Sundays. And what else do we got here?
You know, just getting ready to go into the weekend, make sure everybody's safe, and as we're getting into the winter months, everything's getting a little colder.
So a little bit, not as cold as it should be as fast, right. You know, because I'm still sweating and stuff. But anyway, as you guys can see, and I'd like to say thank you to those of you on YouTube who will eventually see this, and I'm sorry that I've personally been missing in action with my other videos, but I'm coming back next week. Also, to those of you guys on the podcast, Spotify, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, Podbean, thank you so much for tuning in. And to our Facebook, our audience, who is going to provide the commentary for today. So, for those of you guys who are probably wondering what the title means, the hypocrisy. Oh, Amanda says that's dashiki. I'm going to send it to you. I'm going to send you mine, because when I got mine, this address, it was, it fit. Now it's baggy. So I lost a little bit of weight. So, yeah.
Well, I don't know. You know, remember when y'all get stuff like that, y'all have to put in your boob size. And Amanda got them big melons.
I don't fit, because it's okay. Like, I think we both might be able to fit in there. And so anyway, thank you, Amanda. I actually need to get these done over because my hair is growing out. But anyway, so the hypocrisy of black women, ? I put question mark because, you know, I didn't want to just make a statement as if it was a fact or something, but I want to question and see what you guys think. So anyway, you guys might have in the last couple of weeks or so, I'd say maybe the last week, heard about, somebody said, what am I trying to say? Oh, mom said, what you trying to say about me? that's Donovan.
Hey,
no.
That's a real woman right there. more of everything.
Right.
Everything.
So you guys have probably the last couple of weeks been hearing about a guy named Jason Pope. Jason Pope, also known as DJ Kid. He is in, I think it's South Carolina. Forgive me, I don't know exactly where he is, but he is the white guy, if you will, who has claimed to have slept with almost 700 women and girls, giving a lot of them AIDS and HIV. Yeah, it's been quite the scandal. And a lot of text messages and things like that. It seems though he was bragging about these things. Some people have even labeled him an undercover white supremacist, and that he was purposely trying to affect black women who would then in turn affect you.
Right, but here's my thing though.
Hey, Sydney.
With everything that we know about sexually transmitted diseases, why are these young girls running around here having unprotected sex? That's my thing. You can have it. But why are you letting people go?
We're going to talk about the pastor, Mond. I just didn't put him in there, but we're going to talk about the pastor.
Oh, the pussy, or what's
that? Pastor David Wilson.
Yes, okay. Good. We're going to get into that.
Anyway, so you're saying, you know, basically in a day and age, why are people, you know, sleeping around unprotected?
Well, right.
This is the thing. This is why I'm kind of going with the hypocrisy argument a little bit, is because, for one, he's a DJ, and he's a concert promoter, sounds like, too, a club promoter. So he's got the hookup, and I've actually gone on his page where he's soliciting people to come to the club. If you do this, you get $200, come to this club, blah, blah, blah. So he's this club promoter, and, you know, he seems like he's a white boy who's got some black swag and all that other stuff, and, you know, he's got the do-rag and the Jordans, you know. He's the appropriator, if you will.
Appropriate, okay.
And so, to apparently a lot of black women, that was cute. So Cindy San Florence, South Carolina, so South Carolina. Okay. To a lot of black women, in this area, that was appealing and sexy. And not only that, he's also been seen in pictures with a lot of celebrities like Trina, some other rapper named Kia, whatever her name is, and just a bunch of other celebrities. He's also been in a picture with Hillary Clinton. And it comes out that his dad, I guess, is some big-time lawyer, judge.
Right,
some big-time judge somewhere. And so he's got a little bit of pool and clout and something to where he's able to be in both circles, if you will. I guess the more urban circles and then the upper echelon circles. And so I say the hypocrisy because not too long ago, what movie did Lifetime release?
A lot of movies that they
The big one. The big movie. R. Kelly.
R. Kelly.
R. Kelly, if you guys know, I don't want to need to go into all that, was, you know, it is and has been for years accused of abusing young girls and, you know, women who used to be girls like 5 minutes before they were women. And Lifetime had this movie. Everybody took him to task, but especially black women took, or and they should have taken him to task. So I'm not saying they should have been taken to task. R. Kelly should have been taken to task. I'm one of those people who am not apologetic about R. Kelly and anything that he's done. I do not make excuses for him. But a lot of black women especially took R. Kelly to task for the things that he's done and even the things that he's accused of doing as of, you know, the last couple of years ago. Now, we've seen a little bit about Jason Pope here and there, but not to the degree that we heard about it with R. Kelly. I've mostly seen black men talk about, I've mostly seen black men talk about Jason Pope in regards to, wow, what, like, what's going on with you black women? Where y'all are all, like, at the, almost literally dying to give this white man the Kit Kat.
Mm-hmm. I mean, and trying to kill us in the process.
Well, because that's what they're saying his ultimate plan was. Mm-hmm. Was to infect them and then ultimately infect you guys.
Okay, wait, let me ask you this real quick.
Go ahead.
Interrupt you. Is this man currently on charges?
This man is in jail now. So, yes, he is currently...
For attempted murder?
I don't know what it is.
Because what it is when you infect somebody without them knowing, it's supposed to be attempted murder.
I don't know if it's attempted murder, but he is in jail because you're supposed to, you know, tell people these things and that he's doing it intentionally. Yeah, so... he's in jail, but then I've seen some people, another black woman, defending him, saying, "Well, he's a porn star. Mm-hmm. That's what he really is." And people are blowing this out of proportion. And everybody knows, as a porn star, you need to have a test done every so often. And you know, the last time he had a test was in May, and it came back clean. And also, I went on his page, and it seems like, and I forget her name, or they call her Hershey somebody. It's a black woman.
Mm.
Yeah, it's a black woman who was supposed to be his partner in crime.
Hershey.
She's stupid. It's another black woman who's supposed to be his partner in crime, to where they do club promotions together and all this other stuff. And some people say she would help him, sort of like R. Kelly and the people that was with him.
Enable him.
Enable and help lure these girls and these women to him. And so a lot of people say, well, how come she is not in jail too?
So Jeffrey Epstein, like that woman that helped Jeffrey Epstein.
Right. Right. So people are saying, well, he's not really, you know, people are lying. You know, he's this porn star and all. So I don't know exactly what the dude is. But so, and as Sydney says, I did not hear about Jason Pope till it came out. I didn't either. Never even heard of the dude. But come on, Cindy. You know, like, maybe more. I don't know if this is something we should have known about. You also say he's in federal jail. But, I mean, almost 700 women, probably more, 700 women that he slept with. And I don't know if all of them got AIDS and HIV, but it sounds like some of them do. Why are we just not hearing about this? How is it that, I mean, you guys have probably seen the pictures. Have you seen the pictures? There's just droves, and you can Google and look them up. Mm-hmm. Droves and droves and droves and droves of black women in photos with them. And I'm not talking about just no. I'm talking about.
Right here.
Now, I ain't seen nothing like that.
Okay.
But I'm talking about they dress, you know, scantily clad. They in the bed with him, and he's got his hand up in their booty. And, I mean, just the most.
What site is this?
Stupid. I mean, they tongue kissing. They doing the most.
Okay.
You know, and so I'm not even for sure if these women thought that was their man. I mean, what's going on with that? But he was, I'm telling you, he's all on his page. He made it known that he liked dark skin. He's not light skinned women. He liked dark, because all of the women in the pictures with him are very dark skinned. So he talks about, hey, Tay. He talks about having a thing for very dark women. He loves chocolate. Everybody knows I eat and F, you know, chocolate women.
Now, let me ask you this. Do you think that he preys on chocolate women because predominantly a lot of black women have low self-esteem?
No, I don't think that, because I don't think that a lot of dark-skinned women have low self-esteem. I just think he was able to get with women who had low self-esteem, mm-hmm. you know?
Right, that's what I'm saying. He preys on those type of women.
Well, yeah, this is my thing, too, and this is why I got to concede the point, so you write this down, because for me, you're probably never going to agree too often.
Okay.
But I got to agree with the brothers on this and that.
Oh, let me write it down.
Because it is a white man, you know, he gets a pass. You know, he could just do, I'm agreeing with Donovan, yeah. y'all. Do and say whatever he wants, you know, all this. It's just like this, how can I say it? It's just like, it's validation, if you will.
A white man wants
a
me.
A white man wants me,
it.
Yes, and you know.
Versus a black man with a white woman, like, I made it.
I guess, and he wants me, and to be honest, I stole your words, didn't even say you wrote it. You said you've been to South Carolina. It's a quick trip, I think you're saying. Mm-hmm.
I like South Carolina. I've been there several
times. I've never been to
Charleston,
South Carolina.
Charleston.
But to be honest, I didn't think the dude was good looking. Mm-hmm. I don't think he's good looking at all. I mean, it's just my opinion. And so I'm wondering, what about this dude had almost 700, like I said, might be more women, black women, falling all over. I mean, you guys have probably seen the pictures. You know, they just, this the most, doing the most for this dude. And I'm like, South Carolina can't be that big, is it?
It isn't that big. I mean, remember, it's a country.
Right, so all these women?
Well, shit, all I gotta do is park at the local Walmart.
You know what?
They'll be rolling up there, shit.
So, I have to concede that point, and he's saying Florence is poor, so yeah. Sydney's saying, okay, so that might have a little bit to do with it, too, because he was in the habit of throwing money around.
Influential.
Yeah, if you do this, you come to the club this time, or you call, or, you know how people do when they promote stuff. Mm. Then you can win the $200 in the course when the women would win the $200. They would be in the photo with them, and mm-hmm. it may, I'm sure.
Social media.
But just like R. Kelly, I'm sure that was his way of being the Pied Piper to these girls. You know, and as a lot of them said, too, that a lot of these women were underage.
Right, well, you gotta remember, you sent me a couple of memes and stuff where the girl was dancing, and then the black girl would get up and twerk her butt on the dude. And,
oh, you're talking about that one, yeah. I think it was a baseball game
yeah.
or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so, again.
So, you know, these girls, that's what they do. I mean, they just, instant fame, a couple of likes.
Well, I'm just asking black women in general, maybe y'all can help me. Y'all can help me? Is there a little bit of hypocrisy going on here in that we ramrodded R. Kelly. R. Kelly is now in federal prison or jail where he should be. He should be there.
He's awaiting trial. He is innocent until proven guilty.
Innocent until proven guilty, but he's there without the bail. Okay, so R. Kelly is where he should be if indeed he did those things,
right.
Which to me, in my humble opinion, I believe he did. Okay? Now, and a lot of us, especially black women, have a lot to do with making sure R. Kelly got what he deserves. But yet, white chocolate,
Mr. Charlie,
potentially affects 700 black women.
No outrage.
In turn, how many black men were infected? Because
right.
they went back, you know, and slept with them. But yet, he just now being called to the carpet? And even still, I haven't seen a whole lot of people, you know, I'm beckoning upon Lifetime to make a movie about this dude.
Well, yeah.
You know, or nobody's ranting and raving and screaming, so why does? And I don't even know. I'm just asking these questions. Is he getting a pass? Is this Jason Pope, the serial chocolate women AIDS spreader? I don't even know what to call this dude, but is he getting a pass? And is it a little bit hypocritical on behalf of black women to not holler to the high heavens, you know? Because I don't know where Now was with R. Kelly. I'm sure they had a couple of things to say, Now the women's movement. But are they saying anything about Jason Pope? You know, is anybody, like, ringing the alarm again? You know, not saying Hillary Clinton has anything to do with what he's doing, but he's been seen in photos with her. So I'm sure people other than us on Facebook and black people know about this dude. So, yeah, he's in jail, but where's the outcry? Honestly, I think the dude will probably end up getting out, especially since they say his dad is some big time judge, you know, and he's highly connected, if you will. So let me see you guys' comments here. And so Tay says, oh, I saw that dude. He wasn't cute at all. Yeah, that's why I'm like, maybe I'm missing something.
Maybe he's got personality.
Is that what it is? I mean, I'm sure, you know, because unfortunately, now this is where I concede your point too, Donovan. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say that dark-skinned women have low self-esteem. I think women with low self-esteem will fall for what people calling swag. Mm-hmm. He got swag.
Right, right.
You know, because he had swag. Maybe he'll come lose control. Because he's got swag, if you will. You know what I mean? Okay. And so I think that turned a lot of women on. Maybe he made these women feel extra special. I don't know. You guys help me out. And Cindy says, nah. So I did research. Most of them were minors. And they were, you said they were incestuous something.
Incestuous.
Something for 10 years. So I don't know what that means. And then and Cindy says, he ain't lying with that Walmart comment.
I'm telling you,
so you're saying in South Carolina, yeah, all you gotta do is just go
sit in the parking lot at Walmart. And they will just walk on by, because that's where everybody meets in the town. That's an outing when you're going to Walmart.
Oh, God.
Trust me.
So anyway, I don't know anything. I take y'all word for it. But y'all help me out. What's really going on here? You know, because when I read, at first I saw it and I thought, okay, maybe it's like a tabloid type thing. Because I saw it maybe like 2 weeks ago. I thought it was a tabloid type of situation. Okay, people, you know, just one of those funky little satire sites or something. And then I started to see it. I was like, okay, let me read into this. Mm-hmm. And see, you know, if there's some validity to it. And it's, indeed, it's a thing. This dude has been running around. And
you haven't heard about it on the news.
I mean, I don't know if it's on the news by now, but
no,
man.
I mean, you know, I haven't heard no updates on BET or TV,
right, but I'm saying,
or anything like
right,
that.
Right. I mean, where is, I guess I hate to use this, it's so cliche now, but where is the outrage? Where is the outrage? You know, and then Cindy says, D, the issue is we know R. Kelly. No, he ain't getting a pass.
Right.
Okay. Well, I just have to ask because, I mean, yeah, we know R. Kelly. We know of R. Kelly. We don't know R. Kelly. We know of R. Kelly, but
we know R. Kelly. One of his friends of ours was in the group with him.
Right.
360 to R. Kelly, which means it connects to you.
Shit. I ain't got nothing to do with that.
No, but it connects to you.
Right.
You
right.
Connection.
Right. Right.
You know? He used to sing back in the day.
I did. I did. So. But anyway, this is the question I also have. Is what Jason Pope, like, they're both dangerous and heinous acts, so don't get me wrong with that. But is it more dangerous what he did?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what the body count that R. Kelly has, but, you know, to potentially infect 700 black women, and, you know, that sounds like a pretty high number.
Well, like I said, and we don't know R. Kelly's body count, but there are allegations that R. Kelly did spread STDs to.
Yes, I have heard that, and so
victims.
I was really just that really. I thought about that a lot this morning. Like, wow.
But at the end of the day, I have nieces. I don't have any daughters. Thank God, because if I did, I'd be in jail right now. But you know, again, it brings to the question of why aren't these girls protecting themselves from STDs?
Well, you know, because a lot of people who don't protect themselves from STDs, they don't think it's going to be them. He look clean.
I mean,
he look all right.
I understand that, but
damn it, he's got swag. Did you see that do-rag?
Yeah, but it ain't.
Them Jordans.
It ain't enough to.
He smell good.
It ain't enough to limit my life. Sorry.
You know, he got that, you know, woofy woofy.
Trust me, there's a lot of you women out there that be banging. But I ain't.
You ain't banging.
Yeah. I ain't stupid enough to be dipping without no cover.
And Cindy says, investigating for 10 years the feds, so I would be more pissed at the FBI than anyone else. They allowed him to infect minors. So, yeah, so that right there. So they knew this dude was rolling dirty for at least 10 years, been investigated, and he's just been on the creek for 10 years.
Well, can I say this to somebody who's. I'm not from the South, but I was born in the South. I got relatives
in
the South.
Go on and claim it.
No, I'm from California. can I say this? And, you know, those of us that are from the South, we know that a lot of older men prey on underage girls. I'm not saying it's right. But we all know, let's be honest, it's a common thing.
Okay.
So,
but
you know, so him being investigated for 10 years, I can believe that.
Investigated, and I mean, clearly they found something. They found some things that were wrong, because now he's in jail. But let me ask y'all this too. Because this is where, I'm coming up these questions on the fly. Where was they daddies?
Daddy's in jail.
700 of them?
Yeah, you're in jail. Daddy ain't around.
I mean, because I do the numbers. I suck at numbers, by the way. But if I'm doing the numbers game, you got 700, it sounds like mostly minors. Mm-hmm. Like, I already want to ask where they mama. Because, you know, most
mama's
of the time,
in the club with them.
Stop.
Mom was in the club with them. As a matter of fact, when they heard about the contest or whatever it was, Mom was in the parking lot with the baby while she went in there to get the prize. That's pretty much how it rolls. Remember that stripper...
the stripper convention?
Yeah, convention or whatever it was. career day. All the moms are in the parking lot with the babies while the mom's in there trying to get the job. These are just things that go on.
I want to know where their dads were. That's what I want to know. I get it. You know, sometimes, you know, the dad is missing. I get it. But 700?
Yeah, statistically odds of 700.
Okay, if you just go 10. Just do them in increments of 10.
Okay. Out of 10, I'd say 70% are missing. Let's just skip
30%. Yeah, so you got 30%. So, like, how is it that, and this dude is a minor, how is it that this dude is sleeping with, and I don't want to say sleeping, because when we say sleeping, it deduces it it's not. How is he able to sexually abuse all these women? And this dude wasn't hiding.
Well,
he was out in the club. You know, he promoted, he on Facebook
stuff. How about this, Miss D? It's just like after slavery. Okay, they set these slaves free. They're not working anymore. Mr. Charlie's not providing food. He's not providing shelter, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the brother's like, when's the last time you seen Master?
No.
I haven't seen him in a while.
No.
Well, why don't you go over there?
No.
And ask Master to give you something.
I know.
And then, you know, you do the transaction. And so basically what I'm saying is...
You see what he said? Yeah. It's the South.
Yeah. But basically what I'm saying is, we know this stuff goes on. Even the father probably think, well, that's Mr. Charlie. If my daughter gets up with him, we got it.
Okay,
made.
So y'all telling me that... Okay, I'm playing devil's advocate.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Are you saying that the black man is sweet for white chocolate too?
No, that ain't what I'm saying. What I'm saying is... I'm saying if that's Mr. Charlie and he's prominent and has money in the thing, and I come from a, you know, a not advantaged type family, I'm saying go over there. And, you know.
Right. So is he sweet for Mr. Charlie too? Listen, okay. Mr. That's Charlie got the money.
Right. Go over there and get something. Go over there and get
something. I would hate to think that's what's going on. And I know you guys are saying it's in the South. Both of my parents come from the South as well.
Mm-hmm. Via Connecticut.
And I have. No, my mom was born in Valdosta.
I know, Georgia.
Right. And my mom has told me about stories of older dudes, mm-hmm. you know, trying to get at her. And she's like, you know, 12.
Yeah.
She's clearly a minor, you know. And so, I don't want to say it's just old Southern men, they dirt bags, because it's everywhere. But I'm really trying to wrap my head around how is it that this one man, this one white man, is able to just, like I said, he ain't like no viper. He ain't, you know, slithering. He's just, hey, he's pro. If you guys go to his page, Jason Polk, on Facebook, he's talking about how he loves, you know, the chocolate. Mm-hmm. And he's not even, like, discreet about it. He's very explicit in his description of what he likes.
Okay.
So how is it that everybody in this community, Florence, South Carolina, has given this man a pass? Because, listen, especially in the South, in small communities, we've all heard, when you're from the South, you guys are from the South, you probably heard, you know, old dude over there, he like him young. Mm-hmm. He messing with young girls. That, like, that's kind of like the hush-hush, but not so quiet type thing in a lot of communities. So how is it that the cover is not being, because I'm sure there's a lot of people will say, oh, you know, Jason, he liked them young, mm-hmm. you know, chocolate things.
Yeah, tenderonis, yeah.
I ain't advocating violence. And I'm not doing that at all. But nobody thought that maybe, you know, go pay Mr. Pope a visit. And let me holler at you. You know, we hear you around here sleeping with our young girls and, you know, all this other stuff. You giving them money and all. We need to talk to you. Mm-hmm. How come that ain't happening?
It's the culture.
And it sounds like this has been going on since the 90s, if I'm not mistaken. Because one Before girl, that. I guess she had a photo album of her and him from the 90s. And so she released all these pictures of them two together in some pretty, you know, questionable poses and, you know, in the bed and that kind of stuff. So let me get to you guys' other comments. I'm just asking. And Tunkunde, I hope I said that right. Hello, how are you? It's a hypocrisy. Nobody wants to admit it. Many will live to complain. Well, you know, I agree with you. I think a lot of people won't admit it, but I don't think a lot of people even really thought about that in that way. It's a hypocrisy. And again, everybody who abuses women and girls and kids, everybody should be held to accountability. But did you hear about it?
I haven't heard about it.
Donovan didn't hear about it.
I mean, I saw it, but I skipped right
over
it.
But I'm saying you didn't hear about it, like, the outrage and people, talking about Lifetime needs to make a movie about this.
No,
you know, did you see the district attorney?
Nope.
Having a news conference?
No.
You didn't?
No.
Did you guys see the district attorney having a news conference about this at all, South Carolina? I don't know. Maybe they did. No. I didn't see it.
No.
And Sydney says, Donovan, just be honest. We could move to the South and be married in 3 months.
Yep.
That's why I refuse to move to Atlanta and Columbia and or
Charleston. Yep, I mean, you're absolutely right, especially if you're a brother that got yourself halfway together.
So what does that say about, not saying that none, you guys are exceptional dudes, that's not what I'm saying.
Okay.
But what does it say about the women in the South to where it's, you know, these things are going on? And Amanda, if you're still on here, you're in the South. She's not technically, she's not technically from the South, but she's been in the South for about 20 years. So, I mean, what's going on here?
I mean, it's just, I mean, again, in the South, you got black people down there that, and some people are very affluent and they're doing really well.
Mm-hmm.
And they spend a lot of their time in their own communities with their own families.
Got it.
Now, if you come from that side of the town, here's a better example. You guys remember the movie Officer and a Gentleman?
Mm-hmm.
Remembering the part where Foley, the sergeant, was telling the guys about, let me tell you about the local girls.
Right. Okay, yeah.
It's kind of the same thing down there, you know, because in the town that I come from, you're expected to be born there, live there, and die there.
Okay.
So if you got somebody that's new or something different, or Mr. Charlie's got the money, and you can get over to that side, you lived in this little aspect, not so great, and you got an opportunity to go to this side, a lot of people take that opportunity.
Okay, so let me ask you guys this question. Is it plausible to say that if he was allowed to abuse and potentially affect 700 women, he being Jason Pope, the guy, the white guy who has given, allegedly, these women HIV and AIDS. I mean, how is it that all of those women
remain silent?
No, not silent, but felt like he was the optimal thing to do, if you will. Because I feel like when girls are loved properly, especially by the father.
But you got to remember, we're in a different time right now. We're in the 21st century.
But that went back to the 90s, though.
Right, right. No, I understand that. But remember, the super ratchetness started taking place in the 90s.
Okay.
Okay, so you got a mom that's living, you know, that's living a life, and she's out there, you know, partying and doing what she's got to do, and or not what she's got to do, but what she wants to do. And, and it's just like I told that young man. Yeah, he likes doing weed, but when are you going to put your child before your selfishness?
But okay, I get all of that. Yeah, but what I'm saying, you're talking about the dads?
The dads and the moms.
Yeah, because I'm asking, how is it that 700 women and young girls are able to get into the clutches of a monster who, it sounds like it was his, this is just what I read, I don't know how true it is, his divine plan was to infect them on purpose and then give it to black men. That was allegedly his whole scheme.
Yeah, here's my idea why. The crack epidemic that happened in the late 80s, early 90s, that was a very big thing that happened. Now, there's repercussions for that coming into our community. So now you have broken up families, fathers that are going to jail, mass incarceration under the Clinton administration, and done with Kamala Harris and all the other people like that that wanted to do it.
Joe Biden.
So now you have these vulnerable families, these mothers living in Section 8 and in these homes by themselves with no protectors, no warriors of the tribe, because it's all about them and, you know, them doing what they got to do. To me, it's reasonable to believe that you have vulnerable women, girls out there that could be preyed on by people who have been.
And I agree with all that you said. And I buy 70 women. I'll buy 70 women.
But 700.
But 700? What's really going on? I'm confused with that.
Okay, put it like this. If you go to my hometown in the South right now, it is still black and white. They still have two parades, a black parade and a white parade.
Okay.
So I know it's hard for you to grasp that concept.
Because I'm California.
Right, you're a California person. It's hard to grasp that concept. But complacency and what is normal to us is different for them. It's a custom.
And Cindy, I'm going to get to your comment too. Okay, but so to your point though, Donovan, because I believe that, you know, I don't have a reason not to.
Right.
So if everything is pretty much segregated, so you have a black side and you have a white side. This man is white.
Right.
And he's super white.
And white people, where I come from, could go to any side they want and they won't be molested or hurt.
Well, so that's what I'm saying. So, but yet he's able to just...
Yes, absolutely. Especially if he's known as Mr. Charlie, the man with the wealth and whatever in those towns. He's respected and whatever. And what's done in the dark stays in the dark.
So I don't think it was in the dark, though. So this is what I'm saying. So I guess I'm just trying to see if somebody agrees with me that most of those people in the town were okay with that.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Got it.
Exactly.
And Cindy says, D, at 21, your boy could have ran through a lot of women in Charleston. Mm-hmm. They were just throwing it at me, and they were shocked. I said no.
Absolutely.
So to your point, because if we're going from the psyche of somebody, you know, who's thinking, you know, if a white man wants me as validation, you know, and he's, hey, pretty dark chocolate thing, you.
You know.
Yeah, right.
And you know, for those of us that go to visit the South, whatever, they have some very attractive women down there. They do. I mean, you know, body-wise and things like that. I mean, you're a hybrid of that.
I just want to know, though, and I'm not blaming you brothers for this.
Yeah.
Sort of, kind of.
Kind of, sort of.
Little bit. How y'all let this, not y'all, I'm just speaking out there. How y'all let him get a pass?
Fear.
Of what?
White man.
Why?
That's just the culture down there. See, then you got to really understand it.
I'm trying to. But
you're
I'm
never
saying
understand it.
700 of those girls
I have
and women
gone down there.
Have 700 daddies.
Look, I've gone down there in my hometown, my birth town, and I see where the white people are living on these beautiful plantations.
Well, like
and then right across the street.
Yeah.
You're living in Horrorville, okay?
Like Africa.
Right. It's just like that. And for some reason.
Horrorville.
Yeah, the black people will not do anything foolish on Mr. Charlie's side, but they do all kinds of outlandish shit on this side.
Even letting Mr. Charlie come on over.
Yes. Same thing as like we saw in Africa. It's the same thing. They have like a...
Ooh, we did see that in Africa, too. Yeah. A lot of the black women, you know what?
Yeah.
I could be wrong, but I don't think I saw any black men with white women out there. Did you?
Well, you didn't go to the clubs with me when I was...
Right, I didn't go to the clubs. But so, from what I didn't see it, but I saw... I mean, you know what?
Well, we saw a lot of white men with black men.
We sure did.
We sure did.
We saw black men with white men.
Mm-hmm.
And not like just having a regular lunch. It was booed up.
Yeah.
So I don't know what's going on with that, but I do want to know how come they got a pass. I mean, how come just Jason Polk got a pass?
The same way white women were running around in South Africa where a person was murdered there the week before, and she walking around in the dark.
With a purse?
Yeah, without any care in the world, but they're telling us that we got to be afraid. Don't go over here. Don't be over there.
Right.
It's the same thing. It's a mental thing. That's Mr. Charlie. He can go wherever he wants.
I'm asking you. You're in the South. Anybody who's in the South, what is it with the women? Thinking about the context of... Jason Polk being able to sleep and abuse 700 women to the tune of potentially giving them HIV and AIDS. What's going on with the mentality there? In Sydney, you say, D, the only thing they do is screw, for lack of better words.
Yeah.
I'm imagining they do other stuff.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I come from big families. Black people are so deprived in the hometown, my birth town that I'm from. Or at least they were. At least they were.
Do it. Do it to you're satisfied.
My mom's the oldest of 12. My dad's the second oldest of 22 that were born or live births. Even more than that, they say. You know, these. I got cousins, so I come from these two big towns, right? They got babies all over the place. And what kills me is I have some cousins. I love my cousins to death. I do. I love them. But some of these guys... I'll like meet their girlfriends or something like that, and you know, I'll be like, you got a cousin for, you know, a baby for my cousin? Yeah. I'd be like, leave him alone. He's gonna ruin your life.
Well, damn.
But I got cousins coming in and out of prison, and I'm thinking, who was giving this guy pussy?
But that's okay. So I need to know. Inquiring minds need to know what is going on here.
Low self-esteem.
I got the answers, but I just want to see if I know it's low self-esteem, but.
And no protection. The fathers are not in their lives. No protection. These women are procreating.
I'll tell y'all a story.
That just aren't.
When my dad met, and my sister could testify to this. When my dad first met my high school sweetheart, you know, I was 18. He's 18. You know, by the time my dad met her, because you know my dad was having his own issues. We went to my dad's shop. And so. My boyfriend at the time was a high school sweetheart. Mm-hmm. He put his arm around me. It wasn't nothing deep. Mm-hmm. And he told, I think it was my sister or my brother. He better get his hands off my baby. I mean, my dad was besides himself.
Yes.
Like I said, the way he was acting, you just thought he grabbed my butt or something.
Look, when I heard about that incident, I told Amanda, I don't need to meet your dad. Don't need to meet
him. But the point that I'm making is, well, that's my dad. You know, but... Again, 700 girls got 700 daddies and mamas.
Yes.
You know, so I want to know, how come this dude walking was still walking, talking, and breathing, doing what he did to these girls and these women, and how did these girls and these women get to that point to where, because I have to believe that they knew they weren't the only one.
And
they have them knowing when they home, girls are also sleeping with them too.
And a lot of these girls from these little country towns, everybody knows each other. It's just like these guys when they go to jail. They have the baby with the same dude. They're all sharing the same dick. And they don't have a problem with it. Because he's the bad boy in the town or he's this. You know, it's just about status. You know, and that's what's going on down there. This guy has no prospect for you whatsoever, but you're still going to have babies for him.
Yeah, there's a void missing and we need to figure out why. And Cindy says, nope, we ain't going to blame Biden or Harris. If you go to my parents' hometown, Charleston, South Carolina... This happened in the 50s. I got 12 aunts and uncles.
Yep.
I met four.
Yep.
Wow.
And if you were at Charleston with that Air Force base right there, where do you think? They got you and Amici over there too, going to the club on, you know, during the week, trying to get them an airman some benefits.
We wasn't messing with no Jason Paul.
Right. Okay. Got you.
Okay. So you just keep it 100.
But I can say that in Charleston, Sydney. Coming out there as a pilot or air crew in that flight suit, I went out in town. Man, they just jammed on you because they knew. Oh, he's a captain. They just knew. He's flying airplanes. Oh, my God.
And Sydney says, also Atlanta shifted. So they're talking about in South Africa, the white men with the black men.
We were there having breakfast.
I was shocked. I mean, because I'm not, like, shocked when I see, you know, men together. Man. But I was shocked that we was in Africa and they were just...
And the black men were flaming.
Yes, flaming. And that's what I would say.
Flaming.
I don't know if that's derogatory, if it is, excuse us.
Yes, excuse me, but I'm just saying.
But the white men were manly, if you will, and you're right. The black men were on the more on the effeminate side.
Feminine side. We're very fruity.
You could tell that the white man was...
In control.
In control and doing the taking care of and the courting,
he was the
will.
Pitcher. They were the catcher. Yes.
We didn't see all of that, okay?
But you can tell who was the male and who was the female.
I was quite flabbergasted. I'm like, here too?
Right.
Because I'm thinking, you know, in a lot of other countries, that kind of stuff is still taboo.
Right.
But no, we actually were eating breakfast.
Right next to us.
Not only next to us, but we're on the street. Mm-hmm. We weren't inside, and you know, they weren't tucked away in the nook of the restaurant. We were outside on the street watching people walking by and doing their thing. And so it was just kind of like...
You know, and the funny thing for me is when we were sitting there, I was thinking, you know, this guy is probably heterosexual here and probably has a wife and a family, the white guy, on the other side of town. You know what I mean? On right. Johannesburg.
And Perez, what's happening? You says you hit the nail right on the nose. How they allow this cracker to infiltrate with no resistance?
Mr. Charlie has a lot of power in these small towns. I'm telling you guys.
I want to know myself. How is that possible?
Mr. Charlie has a lot of power in these
towns. But, like, is there not one person amongst them? You got 700 mamas. You got 700 daddies. You got the 700 girls and, you know, young women. Nobody.
You're not going to say nothing. Because it's going to cause more problems to you. Because what if Mr. Charlie, I got a bunch of uncles and cousins that work at that factory and I make trouble for Mr. Charlie?
Somebody! One!
You gotta go down there and understand. I'm not saying it's right. I'm just saying
Perez,
that's what's going on.
They need to help us understand this.
That's what's going on.
Because how come there was no resistance? Nobody say, hey.
I'm not gonna say nothing because my job could be a jeopardy.
Is more important than your child's virtue and all of that? I mean, I'm just asking. Cindy says the fast growing HIV population is in the Bible Belt. I have heard that. Which is unfortunate because in the day and age of 2019, with all this education why is this becoming an epidemic? Or you know what I'm saying? Why is it still growing?
Because people just don't get, you know, they're just done. My brother says, yo, y'all, listening on my way home.
All right, now.
I want to say what's up to my brother. He missed cruising the coast. He's one of those Negroes out there that has, you know, nice classic cars and nobody appreciates them. Where, you know, he needs to put in his car over here where he can get stuff done.
Got it. Well, it's so, everybody safe out there, over there then.
Yeah, no, it's better over here. The car's rusting and stuff over there. But for everybody out there, I want you guys to know, Master Sergeant Malloy has ruined his cruising abilities and he's out there wasting a Bentley and a, what's that, 54 Camaro or whatever he's got. I forgot whatever the car is.
Okay.
So well, shame on him.
And Cindy says, and they look dusty as F. Who, the women or the... Are y'all going to get in trouble now? The women or the dudes?
No. Well, yeah, I think he's talking about the dudes because the women are very attractive down there. I mean, you know, a lot of them are robust. And I mean, even Al, before he met you, I mean, you barely meet his standards.
Yeah, I'm a little on the lighter side. He likes him dark, too.
He likes him dark and fit.
Right.
You know?
Maybe that we'll never know, Perez. Maybe we'll never know.
You have to go down there. Wait, in the time you've been to Houston, you didn't see a cloud above everything?
Yeah, I did.
Where Mr. Charlie is kind of like...
I kept to myself a lot in Houston. Cindy often asks, are you sure you want to do this? you want to go to Houston? But, no, seriously. This dude, and if you guys see him, he's like really white. Mm-hmm. He ain't like an ambiguous white dude. You know, like, is he a brother? And then if you see his eyes.
Devilish.
Like Michael Myers. Yeah. They're like black, almost all black. Like a demon.
But he's the guy in the town that's the promoter, knows this person, knows that person.
I mean, he's in pictures with a lot of celebrities, mm-hmm. and, you know, I don't know if that means anything, mm-hmm. but...
Well, you know, to a country person, come on, look how many people get off the buses, and they go to New York, and they come to L.A., and they want to make it. I'm gonna make it after all.
You stupid.
Da-da-da. You know, I mean, that's just how
this is. This is a picture of him with a younger girl. I don't know who this girl is, mm-hmm. but look. He says, I'm 36 at the time. He says, I'm 36 with 693 bodies, all black females. What about you? See?
Yeah. See, I don't even...
I don't know if y'all can see that.
Know what that means. But it's just a sad thing. But maybe we'll get our answer.
I don't know who the young girl is he's kissing or whatever, mm-hmm. but, you know, that's on his Facebook page.
Mm-hmm. And it's going to be there until he gets out of jail.
And I believe he will get out of jail. Mm-hmm.
Of course.
I believe he'll get out of jail. But yeah, Perez, he is pasty white. So that's what I want to know. How is he able to just creep amongst the peoples? Somebody, nobody, you know, said, hey, we need you to,
No.
What you doing over here?
No, like, again.
And for those of you guys in the podcast, we're going to come back with the other section and we're going to talk about, and they want us to talk about Pastor Wilson.
Well, I want to talk about that and I want to talk about colorism.
Colorism. Okay, so you guys stay tuned for that.
But, you know, you got to remember, you know, these small towns.
Cindy says you don't think he's getting out.
Yeah. You know, these small towns, Mr. Charlie has a lot of power.
I guess.
His his nephew's the DA, his son-in-law is the sheriff. I mean, they got a lot of power. There's a lot of connections there. So you gotta, you know.
I guess I just find it very hard to believe that nobody pulled it. And I mean, it might have been somebody who said something to him like, "Hey, what you doing?" You know, and from what I could tell, too, he has black. I saw a picture of a black daughter. So he has a black daughter. You know, with a black woman. I don't know if he has any more kids, but it just. So back to my original question before we close this out. I mean, is there some hypocrisy going on with black women in
What's that? What's the name
of that pastor? Pastor David Wilson. Got it. So is there some hypocrisy going on that we haven't really just screamed to the high heavens? You know, and the guy who actually called R. Kelly out and has been calling him out for years, Jim DeRogatis, he made the statement. He says when he was investigating all the things that was going on with R. Kelly, he said he discovered, bar none, that no one is least cared about than black women and black girls. He said because he has been, you know, telling everybody, you know, just writing about it and doing all that he can to, you know, ring the alarm about what's going on with these girls, and nobody cared, you know. And so I would also venture to say the same thing is true, especially in South Carolina, that this man was able to do this to all these women. And to Sydney's point, the guy has been investigated for 10 years. And I don't know if after 10 years they finally decided to do something, but it took them 10 years.
Yeah.
And he's still just out there just, hey, so, you know, swinging and doing whatever. Yeah. So... and let's see. And Cindy says, I don't think it is like that in South Carolina. It's just dirt poor.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that. Because I thought, obviously every, you know, state has its poor parts. But, you know, normally when you hear South Carolina, you hear about, what do they have out there? Some
military bases.
But some, don't they have, not the Kentucky Derby.
South Carolina has the, not much, really.
It's something.
A lot of NASCAR.
Bowling Green or something out there is supposed to be very affluent. I don't know.
Yeah. Something non-black, I know that.
And Tay says, y'all better leave Pastor Wilson alone. He's out here doing the Lord's work.
That's right.
Yes, he is.
But before we get to Pastor Wilson, let me get into this.
Okay.
I want to talk about, real quick, colorism. Now, why I want to talk about that is because for those of you guys that follow basketball life, okay, this is a show that was started by Shaquille O'Neal's ex-wife, Shawnee O'Neal, and of course they went through a tumultuous divorce and stuff like that, and it's basically a show where ex-basketball wives kind of highlight their lives. Now, the majority of people that go on this show aren't married to basketball players. And
I mean, I don't watch, but I take the word for it, okay?
Yeah, they're not married to basketball players. I used to watch it when it first came out, and I stopped. Got close.
When they got to throwing plates and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. and it was by that one Afro-Latina chick that's always talking bullshit. Mm-hmm. You know, she's a Latina when she needs to be, then she's black when she wants to be, whatever name. She's the one violent one. And then remember Tammy Roman from The Real World? She was on The Real World cast. She was on there because she was actually married to Kenny Anderson. And I not like her because she keeps it kind of real. I gained a lot of weight from the time she was young when we were younger. You know, but she still looks good for herself.
All right.
But the reason why I want to talk about it this time is because there is a particular cast member on there, and her name is Agum Chijindu. Now, why is Agum Chijindu a topic? Is because Agum Chijindu, being from Nigeria, both her parents are Nigerian, but she was born here in the United States, so that means she was ruined. You know, you could be from some other place, your parents, but you come here, you're on some totally different shit. You know, being born here in America. So those traditions that your parents know, you might know it, but you don't practice it. So anyway, Agum Chijindu's on there, and she's a little darker sister, and, you know, a little younger and stuff like that. And so she's out there. What is her name? Oh, Evelyn Lozada. Is that her name? Evelyn?
Lozada,
or whatever her name is. She basically called Agum a monkey, or made a reference to that, whatever. And the reason I'm bringing that up is we're talking about colorism. Like I said, Evelyn Lozada, she was married to a dark motherfucker herself.
So Evelyn Lozada, whatever her name is, she called the darker sister a monkey.
Right.
Oh.
Or on Twitter or something like that. And it all this outrage, and then Agum said, see, this is what we're talking about. Look, you know, when things aren't going good, whatever it is. But here's the funny thing, real quick, let me make a disclaimer. Agam Chichindu is from the Inland Empire. She used to be a professional football player, a lingerie football league. She played for the Los Angeles Temptations, which they used to play out there at the Ontario Key Arena.
Okay.
Out there in Ontario. And she's a San Bernardino Valley alumni. And that is where I first met her. And I used to date her sister.
Now you're talking about something going 360.
Right. I used to date her sister. Okay. So I remember when Ogden was a younger chick.
Okay.
But she brought up a good point in how these shows, and you know, to me, she shouldn't be on the show. I even sent her an email saying, yeah, I'm proud of you, but you really shouldn't be on these shows. But even within our own caste system, we've got colorism going on. And with these stupid-ass woman shows, it's showing how we are still affected by this colorism that is going on. And to me, it's totally unnecessary, but it's showing the tomfoolery that our women are doing. Because, you know, I mean, Ogham being a dark-skinned woman, I've seen her with the blonde wig looking like a Morlock and all that stuff like that. It's just ridiculous. So, you know, we have a big problem still within our own women. You know, here this Evelyn Elizondo, she's a Latina when she wants to be. Again, let them have their own show. Let us have our own show.
Well, you know that'll never happen. But, yeah, I agree with you in that. I mean, I don't know a whole lot about what you're saying, but, yeah, the colorism has always been there. It's here now. It probably always will be. For some reason, you know, we have this thing with if you're not this, you know, shade, there's something wrong with you. My dad always said, and my mom used to say a lot, too, the older people used to say, what if you black, get back. If you brown, stick around.
Right.
If you yellow, you mellow. If you white, you all right, or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so we still have that attitude. And you can kind of even tie that into the whole Jason Polk thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because here's this white man who's able to walk amongst all these black, mm-hmm. very beautiful sisters, if you ask me.
Mm-hmm.
And he's having this way with them, and nobody's questioning them. But could that have been, this is another question I guess we could ask, could that have been a black man doing what he did in that community, abusing 700 women and girls and getting a pass? Could a black man have gotten away with that?
Oh, absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Right.
You can go back and read on that stuff.
And let's see. And then so, Cindy says, D, that child trafficking charge, he ain't getting out. So he's got, that's what it was.
That's why
they got him for child trafficking.
Okay, good. Got him for something.
I mean, they should have gotten him for that, but, you know, damn. And Amanda says, it's not colorism. Them bitches are just mean bullies and evil.
Right. Right, but, you know, I'm not defending Ogham or anything like that. But then, you know, Ogham was known in the football league for bullying. Well, you know, she's a football player, but, you know, like I said, sometimes things could come back around. But,
right.
You know, knowing her as a person, she's a very, if you know her, she's a very sweet girl. She really is. Her sister, you know, was very
Well,
nice.
Then what is she doing on that show?
I don't, you know, but here's my point for those that are listening and those that are watching. Ogham is from the Inland Empire, which is not far from L.A. So can dreams come true? And, you know, you can do things. As a matter of fact, Ogham is dating a basketball player. He isn't an NBA player, but he's an international player. So, but she played professional football, and she made the right connections and got in there and, you know, and marketed herself and did really, really well. So, yeah, you could make it in L.A. if you're willing to pay that price.
Okay.
But now, you know, her business is all thrown out there, and, you know, you're going through all this drama and stuff. And I guess in the reunion show, what I picked up off of her Twitter, they put her away from the main cast members. Maybe Shantae knows more about it because I don't follow that stuff.
I'm trying.
But my point is, that show should have never come back to TV because when it started going into the dumps.
Well, there's clearly an audience for it, which is why it's back.
It's back.
Yeah,
and,
it's an audience for it.
You know, it's just a sad thing. But you have these so-called beautiful black women that are acting like fucking buffoons on this show, and we got young girls that are watching this and thinking this is the way you're supposed to act or whatever you need to do to make it, you know, make it. You got to get ratchet and become hoish. That's what you're going to do. You know?
Right.
So you got to make money.
And Tay says, oh, you want to talk about OG.
OG, yes. Ogham Chichindu, yes.
Tay says, Evelyn Lozada is a racist piece of shit.
Mm-hmm.
She's always been on some bullshit, and OG should have cracked her damn head in for talking slick.
Yep. I heard there was something that went down.
Sydney says, I know Evelyn Lozada's mom and her stepfather. Mm-hmm. They don't F with her. I still live in the project last time I was there. Damn. Mm.
Yeah, that's what I heard. I mean,
wow.
When the show first started, they went back to Evelyn's home back in New York where she's trying to show her humble roots and stuff.
Right.
And I heard that she just...
If I get out of here!
Yeah, I mean, Evelyn was... She was dating one of the basketball... Paul Walker, one of the basketball players. And, you know, she was getting... You know, he was cutting her off all this money and stuff. And she did. She never went back to take care of her mom.
Her peoples.
You know?
Wow.
I mean, at least take care of your mom.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't care about anybody else, but take care of your mom.
And Tay said, same mess with that went on with Amara La Negra. And her beautiful Afro-Latina self. Well, I know a little bit about her. They was hating on her. And Cena says, to answer that question, yes, black men in Florence would get away with it. Yes. Wow.
I need to move to Florence.
Yeah. South Carolina, Florence, South Carolina, you need somebody to come down there and talk to the people. Talk amongst the people.
They will run you out of there so quick. Have you heard of the movie In the Heat of the Night?
Yes, I have.
Look, but Demetra be like, you can call me Demetra Tibbs.
I need to talk to y'all. There's something ain't right. Something in the water. Something ain't right.
We'd be like Mississippi Burning. It'd be Florence Burning. They run you right out of that town.
Anyway, let's do it, y'all. Let's just go ahead and just go on the segue to Pastor Wilson.
Okay, let's do it.
Who is Pastor Wilson?
I have no idea. Is he the same as my good friend Thaddeus Matthews?
Kinda, but all right.
Isn't he the pussy eating pastor?
Can you say that on YouTube?
I'm not sure. Is he the pussy eating pastor? It's a question. Did I say something wrong? Am I supposed to get censored?
That be the pastor.
Okay, that be him. Okay,
that's the pastor.
That's the pastor. Okay.
I was trying to find a more civil way to say that.
Carpet munching pastor. How about that? Is that better? Carpet munching. Static munching.
Pastor David Wilson.
What is with the pastor?
Been trending. He was trending on Twitter yesterday. He was number one trending at one point in time.